Teamwork is a very crucial part of most multiplayer video games, but despite how much we play video games online in a team, a lot of people are still pretty crappy teammates. What's up, guys? Chaos here. Today, we're going to be checking out 10 ways that you can be a better teammate. I have always prided myself on being a good teammate, no matter what the game. I know the main focus of this list will be Battle Royale games like PUBG and Fortnite, but all of these tips can definitely be applied to other genres as well. So without further ado, let's get started. Be sure to send this video to a buddy who you think could use a little advice. Maybe they're not a very good teammate. Kicking off our list at number 10 is simple. Tell your teammates where you are and where you're going. That's right, this is a simple tip that a lot of people seem to not do when they're in the heat of the moment. In a game like Fortnite, any other Battle Royale game for that matter, it is extremely important to always know where your teammates are and where they're going, so that way, if they get attacked, you know where you have to rush in order to help them. However, if you go on your own little journey away from your team, you lone wolf it without telling anybody, and you start getting shot at, you cannot get mad at your buddies for not helping you when you die. Whenever you're going away from your teammates, let them know where you're going, where you are currently, so they can readjust if they need to. And drop a like on this video if you have ever been or been in the other position where a teammate takes off, doesn't tell anybody, gets shot, gets down, dies, and then blames it on you guys for not picking him up quick enough. At number 9, learn to give good, quick call-outs. If you see the pros playing any type of game, not just any Battle Royale, I'm talking about any competitive game, they are constantly chattering. That's right. You need to know how to give good call-outs if you want to be a good teammate. Over there is not a good call-out, and neither is through the door or on the street. Those are extremely vague call-outs that can mean any number of different directions. When you're calling out an enemy, give their exact direction and something noticeable nearby. Maybe north 310 by the hut or southeast by the rift spawns, whatever it may be. When calling out enemies, you don't want to leave any room for miscommunication, but you also don't want to tell your friend something that is going to take too long to say. So practice giving quick, precise call-outs that give an exact location without taking up too much time or leaving any room for error. At number 8, don't be a douche. Don't steal loot. Come on. If your teammate kills someone, let them have first dibs on the loot. They're probably pretty nice. They're probably going to give you something. If you're in the middle of a fight and someone dies, then it's a little more acceptable to rush in and grab what you need so you can get back into battle. But if your teammate kills someone and they drop a scar or a heavy shotgun, don't run in there and take it and make your teammate have to ask for it back. Just let them have first dibs on the loot they provided for the team. And if the enemy drops something you wanted, ask them for it. Stealing your teammates' loot is like when you're in school and that one kid takes full credit for the group assignment when they barely did anything. Don't be that kid. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 7, don't wait for approval of loot. Speaking of loot, this is something that's very important for newer players. When you have an open slot and you see some healing items or explosives when you're playing squads, don't hesitate to just pick stuff up. A lot of newer players feel like they need to ask their teammates for approval of getting any loot that they're thinking about picking up, and I understand why. Fortnite can be pretty punishing for new players, and when you're teamed up with someone more experienced, you don't want to make dumb mistakes. But if you have an open inventory slot and you see something you want, pick it up. Don't ask for approval for picking something up. Just pick it up, and if it turns out you don't need it, it's simple. Drop it later. You don't want to not pick something up because you didn't have approval, and then you end up actually needing it later. You could be the hero, and everybody forgets the storm is coming, and you happen to pick up those 15 bandages, and you can divvy them up, and you save the day. You're the hero. At number 6, do wait for approval of engaging. Right, now, you shouldn't always ask for permission with loot pickups. You should always wait for permission before engaging an enemy. When you see an enemy team running by you, the worst thing you could ever do is just open fire without telling your teammates. What if your teammates are low on ammo? What if your teammates are in the middle of healing? What if your teammates are AFK? What if your teammates have a sniper they could have picked up off one of the enemies and you didn't give away your location? I mean, always tell your teammates where enemies are before opening fire at them. And if your teammates tell you they're not ready to fight, don't pick the fight. Don't fire the shot. Cracking into the top 5. Now, do what they say. Speaking of not doing something your teammates told you not to do, this is a very key part of good teamwork, all right? Listen up. If your teammate tells you to do something, and then you do the opposite of that, it is going to seriously mess with your dynamic. What if they just stop telling you things because they don't feel like you're actually going to listen to them? Well, then you'll have the situation where you're a team that doesn't communicate. And then you'll end up playing like crap because you'll stop giving call-outs. You'll stop playing as a unit, and everything will fall apart. Your team, your camaraderie will crumble. If you want to be a good teammate, you actually have to work with your team. And if your teammate tells you to not do something or not go somewhere, you need to listen to them or at least talk to them about the plan that they're telling you about if you don't agree with it. And number four, keep an eye out for your teammate's favorite gun. This is a good one, okay? One thing that really helps out when playing Battle Royale games in a team is having a specialist with you. You know, those players who are really good with a certain type of weapon. Maybe you have a friend who is really good with a sniper, or you play with someone who's a really good shotgun player. Let me know in the comment section. What specialist are you? What are you really, really good with? Whatever it may be, you should always keep an eye out for those weapons that your teammates are good with. You want to win, right? That's the whole point of this game. Even if you end up finding a really valuable weapon, you should give it to your teammate if you know they're better than you are with it. If you're not a very good sniper and your teammate is, give them the gold bolt. Don't just hold on to it because it's shiny and gold. Give it to somebody that can help you get that dub. Number three, for the love of Pete, don't go AFK. How many of you have been in this frustrating situation where you're about to do something super important in the game, and then all of a sudden your teammate just leaves on you to go send a text or get some food or go to the bathroom? You really, really don't want to be the person in your squad that holds everyone up or even gets the squad wiped because they were attacked and you were not there to help. If you need to step away for a second, tell your teammate beforehand or wait until there is a safe moment, like in between matches, okay? Don't be the guy who just disappears out of nowhere without explanation because they needed to go get their pizza or their Hot Pocket out of the microwave. Seriously, there is nothing that can ruin friendships and teams quicker than you being the absolute pivotal reason that your team got completely wiped. At number two, don't be hostile. One of the worst things you can do to your teammate when you're trying to get some wins is honestly being a dick to them. It's bashing them. Everybody messes around with their friends, and a little trash talk can be healthy at times, but when you start insulting your teammates and telling them they're garbage, you can't be surprised when they stop trying to help you out, or honestly, they just stop playing with you altogether. Teamwork is a two-way street, or more than two, and it's never just one-sided. Even if you're playing with someone who isn't that good, they're not going to get any better at the game with you just because you get pissy with them. Keep your cool. Don't lash out at someone just because they're not playing the way you want them to play. That's the quickest way to possibly lose a teammate. And you know the best teammates out there? It's gonna sound a little corny, but the best teammates are those teammates that make everybody around them better. Even if you're playing with complete noobs, a good teammate is going to make them better. And finally, play it out. You heard me right. Play it out. This is one of the toughest things to do in team-based games where you can get knocked out before your team does. Now, it can be hard to sit in spectator mode after you're dead and watch your buddies keep on playing it out. But don't be the guy who always demands that everyone else leave the lobby just because you messed up and you got killed. Now, if I die, I just start shoutcasting the rest of the match. That's what I do. That's how I have fun. If your teammates are okay with backing out since it's the very, very beginning, that is one thing. But it's entirely a separate deal when it's already down top 50, top 40, top 30, top 20, and someone dies and they're like, hey, back out. Don't be that guy. It's selfish. Plus, if your teammate is having a good game, or I mean, let them play it out. What if they've got 8 kills? What if they've got 12 kills? Don't kill their groove. Don't kill their vibe. Maybe they'll end up carrying you to a win. Don't forget, if you don't back out of the match, if you don't disconnect, you're still going to get credit for that win. A dub is a dub, whether or not you are alive to get it or not. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 ways to be a better teammate in any type of game. I know we reference mostly Fortnite or Battle Royale, but this works in any team games or even in any co-op games. There are multiple ways to be a bad teammate, and there's really only one way to be a good teammate. Just follow all these things on this list. You want to be the good teammate. You want to be the one that people hit up and say, hey, I want that guy to roll with us today. If you guys enjoyed the video, drop a like, make sure you subscribe. If you're part of Team Chaos, be a good teammate, turn on those notifications, because that's the guarantee, at least they say it is, that you'll get these videos in your sub box. I hope you guys have a fantastic night. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Be a good teammate.